At this moment, I'm building and testing the MicroTracer version 3. I'm now at the stage that the controller has been installed, the current amplifiers, the boost converters and the high voltage switch, and I'm now testing these components. Because usually in a large project like this, it's not a good idea to build everything in once, program it and then test it, and then to find that it doesn't work, because then you will have a hell of a job finding out what is wrong. But what is much better is to build it bit by bit, piece by piece, and test every bit of it as you go along. So what we have here in the center is the MicroTracer. On the right side is my PIC programmer, in-circuit programmer, which is connected to the MicroTracer. The MicroTracer is also connected to via serial link to my laptop for the graphical user interface, and I don't have a tube connected to it at this moment, but just a simple load resistor, so that we should get a linear relationship between the anode voltage and the anode current. What I'm testing here is the current limiting circuit. So a new feature of this version is that there is a current limiting feature. It consists of two parts. One part is a hardware part. That's a hardware provision which limits the current to about 250 milliamps. That still could give too high dissipation in the switch when you have a full short circuit. And for that reason, there is also a software switch which measures the current flowing. You can actually adjust the maximum current. When it finds an overcurrent condition, it gives an interrupt which switches off the high voltage supply within several tenths of a microsecond. And actually, that's the bit I'm testing today. So I will place now my camera in front of the laptop. Let's switch off the light a bit. The picture is not that good. I don't know the reason for that. There is a strange white spot in the center, but never mind. So what you can adjust here in the graphical user interface is the type of measurement. I've selected here a measurement of the anode current as a function of anode voltage. I'm not stepping the grid voltage here. I take a start voltage of 30 volts, stop voltage of 300 volts at about 20 intervals. Let's adjust the scales a bit here to 300 volts and 100 milliamps. Okay, let's start the measurement. You see a very nice linear relationship between anode voltage and anode current, as it should be. I'm very happy that it is this way, because in the version 2 there was some offset and drift and noise in the signal, and here it's a very nice linear signal. And what you see happening here is at about 220 volts that the current limiting circuit kicks in at about 84 milliamps. That's the value I've set it to. It kicks in, it switches off the anode supply, giving zero anode current for the remaining points. So that worked actually very beautiful. We can also follow that on the oscilloscope. Let me put it a bit higher here. So what you see here is the voltage drop over the current sense resistor. I will start the measurement now. You will see the voltage increase, measurement pulse of 10 microseconds, and at a certain point you see the big 1 millisecond pulse disappear, making place for a very narrow pulse, which is the length remaining of the measurement pulse. I can show that a bit more clear when I zoom in a bit, put the time base to 5 microseconds per division, and I will now restart the measurement. Yeah, there we have the 1 millisecond pulse, and now kicking in is the current limiting circuit. So you see that the pulse is now about 20-30 microseconds. It even becomes more clear when I also show here the pulse that I use for triggering, and that is actually the signal which drives the LED in the optocoupler for the high voltage switch. So I will now again switch on. Yeah, you see the pulse. And there we have the current limiting circuit. And you see now here, what we see actually is here the moment when the processor tells the LED to switch on. About a few microseconds later, the high voltage switch switches on. That's the delay of the optocoupler. Then here, actually, the overcurrent situation is detected. Within a few microseconds, the processor shuts off the high voltage switch, and then it takes about 10-15 microseconds for the high voltage switch to respond and to switch off. So the total event is limited now to about 15 to 20 microseconds, which is actually safe.